Welcome to Write Club Phoenix! Christ Club audience, are you ready?
Love is good.
Mr. Ashanti Files with Reflect in 3, 2, 1, begin. Speculum. I had a hysterectomy yesterday. For 24 of my 36 years, I have planned life around a monthly cycle of blood. My uterus and fallopian tubes were removed because there was something in me that prevented Ashanti from being the best she could be, 10 to 15 days a month. My verses come to you today by word of mouth. As he stands before you reading this, it's a good chance I'll be back at the house, reflecting. Collecting, protecting, deflecting from the truth. See, talking about vaginas, coochies, pussy, and cunts is socially acceptable. But talking about the part of me that carried and lost multiple babies will undoubtedly make you uncomfortable. Too bad. See, it wasn't vaginas that Congress wanted to control. It was the uterus. It wasn't vaginas that the Supreme Court disenfranchised. It was the uterus. That apple-sized organ deep within every biological woman that causes men to envy us, hate us, rape us, berate us. The uterus. It's not vaginas that get teenage girls teased as she crosses her legs and bleeds through her jeans in fifth hour. Yes, I'm talking about periods. And no, bleeding for 10 to 15 days every month is not normal. Being afraid to go outside is not normal. Bringing extra pants to work that you have to hide is not normal. But what has become normal is the silence to a woman's pain, to a black woman's pain. To a black woman's mother's pain. To a black woman's mother's daughter's pain as she asks me if I am on my period again because she just started cramping. The vagina knows pleasure, but the uterus knows only pain to the point where we as women have learned to disdain it ourselves. And even now, as I delve into the relationship between my body and my mind, I find that I am forced to pause frequently. Did I ever thank her? That messy organ for carrying life? Did I ever apologize to her for the days the strife was so intense that I threatened my own life because I just couldn't live with her? Why am I so uncomfortable talking to myself about my own body? Why is there this disconnect that I am just beginning to spend time on reflecting? Why now? I feel my heart rate speed up. I feel my stomach clench. I feel that something is missing and my mind is trying to make sense of what happens next. Not having a uterus now lets me swim whenever I want. I can wear white every day, but what was lost in the medical necessity of the procedure was the possibility that one day I could be whole with her, instead of blaming her for all the bad. Without my uterus, I can no longer dismiss my sadness as hormones. I actually have to confront and inquire about my emotions. For over 2 decades, I got lost to the motions of devaluing my thoughts and feelings because I had been indoctrinated as a woman to always second-guess myself. Was it really injustice, or was I just cramping? Am I reacting because of hormones, or was that comment truly dismissive and insulting? I have gotten accustomed to my uterus taking the blame for my insecurities. Brushing off negative tendencies like dust from a car after a sandstorm. Why was it that objecting to every insult thrown at my sex was buried so deep inside of me that I let my conscious mind forget that it was even hurting in the first place? Why is this original sin woven within all of us women, even if we don't believe in God? The shame indoctrinated so deeply that for years I believed that bleeding profusely was a normal part of being a woman. That continuing on despite debilitating pain was a strength. And even as the clots got larger and the nausea kept me from eating for days, I was proud of myself because at the end of the day, I could take it. The world picks up my gender. The world picks up my race. The world chooses pieces of me that I've tried hard to encase in glass and stone and diamonds. It leaves behind the pain, the agony I proclaim as I struggle to name myself. For years I bled, soaking pants and sheets and flipping the mattress repeatedly until it was permanently more red than white. And I hated it. I hated the visual reminder that I was biologically less than. I hated that the tremor in my voice would be dismissed as pain instead of rage. I hated that before every time I got on stage, I edited myself because I felt having a uterus would invalidate my words and life experiences. I forced myself to perform something palatable, to speak only about what could be obviously seen. And now as I ponder the future without that cramping, bleeding thing, I wonder what will happen next. I find it poetic that as I am finally coming to grips about this illusion of silent strength and deceptive duality of womanhood, I am physically incapable of sharing my thoughts, my feelings, my words, myself. That a man is on this stage reading about my life as a woman, will he get the same response? Will the audience think that he's so ahead of his time? After the show, will he be flaunting his public speaking skills with modest nods and agreements of how powerful this piece was? Will it even matter in the end? I imagine that this whole exercise is odd as an audience member, listening to words written by a woman being spoken by a man, the man who has had to catch me from falling after I'd been weak from blood loss, the man who encouraged me to have hope when pain was unbearable, the man who cried with me as I mourned the loss of our child. The man who promised me that despite my uterus being gone, I was still a woman. His woman. I'm writing this as a reflection. Ryan is my reflection. He is who I see when I am strong enough to acknowledge my talent and skill. He is who I am when being me is unacceptable. He is the same image mirrored. Right hand becomes left hand. Insecurity becomes beauty, and pain is simply that.
The words of This Is Ashanti Files, spoken by Ryan Files, her husband. I'm in tears.